Hello and welcome to some more This Week in Star Citizen. It is the 13th of August 2024. What have CIG got planned in terms of updates, events and releases this week, as well as where are we with that Alpha 3.24 cargo patch, which is currently making its way through the PTU phase on its long journey, hopefully not too long, to live. From the This Week in Star Citizen post from CIG, phase one of the ship showdown wraps up this week, and your submissions have been truly legendary, from stunning model builds and captivating paintings to hype videos and even inventive food creations. The feeds have been overflowing with creativity. We're now narrowing down the top 16 vehicles as we gear up for phase two. And don't forget, the Sweet 16 will be available to fly for free from the 15th of August to the 22nd of August. Something I'm not 100% sure on is this a free fly event for everyone? Can everyone play Star Citizen for free during that period? Or is it just players that already have access to Star Citizen? We'll find out soon enough, later this week, in fact. But it's going to be a load of cool ships for players to try, because it's going to be the most popular fireball ships in the verse. CIG continue. We're thrilled to share that later this week we'll be bringing back a small wave of CitizenCon general admission tickets. These will be very limited and will likely go very fast, so if you're out there kicking yourself for not getting a ticket sooner, this will be your chance to pick one up and join us in Manchester on October 19th and 20th. Keep an eye on Spectrum for an announcement on the exact day and time these tickets will be restocked. So I believe that the reason they've got some extra tickets is because of refunds and cancellations on tickets, or some people not being eligible for tickets for reasons. It's only going to be a very, very small amount. Something else you might be interested in is that there are Bar Citizens going on all week in Manchester during CitizenCon. I also suspect there'll be loads over the world that you can join in with. There's going to be watch parties, all that sort of stuff, and you can just, you know, tune into watch CitizenCon for free on the Star Citizen Twitch channel. That is going to be what most people do anyway. Zin and I and some of our friends will be attending, and we'll be covering the event to our best of our ability while we're there, but it's going to be more that when we come back, we'll summarize all of the panels and tell you what we learned while we were there. Speaking of CitizenCon, applications for the cosplay contest are still open until the 27th of September. So if you're interested, you can join that via the links down below. I'll chuck a link to all the source information here, and you'll be able to click on that and join the cosplay competition. Sometimes the cosplay stuff is pretty good, sort of the effort that people make, and I like the funny ones where people dress up as like Big Benny's machines. So what else is going on this week? Well, later Tuesday, the narrative team will be publishing the Whitley's Guide on the Cutlass Red, Zin's favorite ship, and I think it's going to do pretty well in the ship showdown, although maybe the Cutlass Red won't be in it, maybe it'll be the Cutlass Black instead, but it'll be the Cutlasses. You know, this was a story, or at least a little feature, that originally appeared in the Jump Point magazine, the subscribers mag. Developed to counter Drake's reputation as an outlaw brand, the Cutlass Red proved its value as a medical ship almost immediately during an unexpected tragedy on Coral. Now, interesting, the Cutlass Red allowed you originally to respawn people in its medical beds, and then, because they're tier 3, and then they went, no, you can't respawn people in medical beds, and now you can respawn people in medical beds again. Hooray! I say medical beds, in tier 3 medical beds. I suppose that's all medical beds currently. We'll see where that goes in the future. On Wednesday, they're publishing the Squadron 42 monthly report. Sort of the newsletter that was sent out to people actually gets published as an article, so if you're not getting that newsletter, you can see it then. I've just realized that we have not made a video on the Squadron 42 monthly report, so I'll get on that straight after this video, because we're expecting some big announcements for Squadron 42 at this year's CitizenCon. I'm expecting to see celebrities from Squadron 42 at CitizenCon. I'm expecting to for them to give a release date for it, but yeah, so it's in the polish phase still, Squadron, and very excited for it. Thursday, inside Star Citizen. This is going to be a trip down to the surface of Pyro's planets and moons to explore the non-combat aspects of life in that star system, as well as a chance to meet two factions just trying to make their way through the verse, the Citizens for Prosperity and Headhunters. Thursday is also the start of phase two for the ship showdown. So we'll know what the top 16 ships are. We'll have that free fly event to whatever extent it is. And it will be the first 1v1 vote that you'll have between two ships. Assumedly, ships compete within their category first. So the industry ships will fight each other, if you see what I mean, and then the combat ships will fight each other to see who's best in that category, and then they'll start get paired off against each other beyond that, because it's the top two ships in each category that will have made it into the ship showdown. And there are eight categories. Tell us what your favorite flyable ship is in Star Citizen in the comments below. Friday, we've got a Star Citizen live Q&A with the Frankfurt level design team talking about contested zones and asteroid bases. This is going to be pretty juicy because I think contested zones, there's so many questions about, because they refer to them as MMO style dungeons and like the framework for that, but also it's very much like a extraction shooter where you're getting loot and enemy players can turn up as well during that, and we want to know what plans they have for that and how it's supposed to be played and their vision for it, because there are lots of issues that could happen with people sort of just camping you and things like that, and I'm really interested in contested zones. I think they could be genuinely great. Some of the questions that have already been put up on the question thread, which you can add to and vote up as well, the top ones were, will asteroid bases come to the Arran Halo and other places around Stanton as well? So Arran Halo is a big asteroid field in the middle of the system as a big giant ring and has these big Crusader customs gates in it. Will there be asteroid bases without enemy NPCs for non-violent gameplay as well, e.g. scavenging, environmental puzzles, etc.? How does the meat grinding aspect of the contested zones align with the Death of a Spaceman? I assume the rewards have to be good enough to be worth the risk. I don't know if you want to spoil this, but can you give us some hints what types of rewards we can expect to find in contested zones and asteroid bases? Are there plans, or does the toolset allow for creation for non-direct asteroid bases? So yeah, are we going to see functional ones around? Is the old plan of allowing players to have their own asteroid hangars still on CIG's backlog? So that's a good question, because asteroid bases that they're talking about aren't player bases or bases at all, really. They're sort of asteroid space stations. How is Death of a Spaceman connected to contested zones? It seems like dying might not be that big of an issue anymore. What is being done to avoid bottlenecks and other obvious camping spots that would negatively affect players' experiences in contested zones? So I am really interested in answers to pretty much all of those questions that were asked. Obviously, some of them are sort of like overlapping, really excited for that episode of Star Citizen Live. Saturday, with some stuff going on as well. XGR is doing a Nino Racing Cup. It's going to be racing across multiple categories starting at 4 p.m. UTC on their Twitch channel. Also, if combat is more your speed, you've got Atmo Esports 2v2 dogfighting fight or flight tournament going on. That begins at 4 p.m. UTC as well. You can check that out on their Twitch channel on Saturday too. Star Citizen now for 3.24 PTU update. They recently put out another patch, and over the weekend they were testing the blockade runner missions, but they put out another patch since then. This patch they just put out fixed a ton of issues. Local areas being missing after server recovery, elevators taking you to the wrong hangar, cargo grid of the Aurora being difficult to use, players are now actually able to retrieve and spawn vehicles properly in their hangars, or at least more properly, less bugs with that. Attempting to withdraw items from storage kiosks previously resulted in an infinite load as well, so they fixed a ton of stuff. We're still in wave one. They were supposed to go to wave two. Well, they wanted to go to wave two over the weekend, but it should go to wave two real soon. The blockade runner is not going to be run in today's build, as far as I'm aware. CIG saying that they're focusing on updates and fixes to that before running that global mission again. And yes, it very much needs some fixes, some stability stuff. And there were some problems with actually dropping off the Zeta Prolinade that you need to continue the mission, to finish the mission. But the core constituent parts of it work fine. It's just the bringing of it together and the dropping off of the cargo did not. And if they solve that and potentially issues with so many players queuing for hangars and the hangar problems, we're going to be in a good state for Blockade Runner. But yeah, there's still much to do with this patch before it goes to Open PTU and live. I still think we could be on track for a end of August live release, or the very least an Open PTU by the end of August. Open PTU meaning everyone's got access that's got Star Citizen access. But yeah, that's it for your Star Citizen updates today. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Have you been playing in 3.24 wave 1 PTU? Are you looking forward to wave 2 Open PTU, all that sort of stuff? Are you excited for that? Has it been terrible for you? Do you think it's going to be the best patch ever because you love cargo, or are you keenly awaiting Alpha 4.0, which is the next major patch to turn up after this. And this patch, I suppose, was effectively just an offshoot of 3.23.x, because they went, oh, it's going to take a while before we get it in the game, these features, and let's give it a 3.24 moniker. Are you going to be voting in the ship showdown? What ship do you want to win? Are you trying to get yourself a CitizenCon ticket, or are you going to be watching it from the comfort of your own home? Whatever your questions or thoughts, I would love to hear from you in the comments below. Chuck them down there. And thank you so much for watching. You stand at the pearly gates. The winged being there weighs your sins against the weight of a feather. You are found wanting. Not a problem for NordVPN.com/BoredGamer though. Just change your location. Boom! You're in! Bypass your sin. Get NordVPN.com/BoredGamer. Probably not a tagline that Nord wants, bypass your sin, but that's what they're getting. Maybe they want one about its added security, privacy, or accessibility. Pah! Everyone knows that. You get that at a touch of a button. Click these links below to get great deals on that VPN service. Every month we give away a ship, and this month of August is all about your favourite ships, because it's the ship showdown. My favourite ship is the Mercury Star Runner, and I don't want to give one of those away, but I will. It's a fantastic little multi-role, multi-crew ship. It's got a bit of cargo space, it's got room for a little vehicle, it's got a good amount of firepower, perfect little mission runner. In the future it's going to have data running, it's good for smuggling, it's got lots of secret little hidey holes. I absolutely love this ship. All you need to do to be in for a chance of winning that is comment on any of my videos made during August. Also, I would love to know what your favourite ship is. If you would like to further support the channel, consider just commenting or liking, subscribing. That all helps. But also there's the join button under my videos. That goes a huge way to allow us to make daily content on Star Citizen. There's also Patreon, sharing the videos, direct donations. There's links to all of that down below. Thank you so much for watching to the end. You take care and have a great day.